And this is relatively a big topside, and this gives additional challenges. You can compare the Dogger Bank C project with approximately 900,000 minis.
The contribution of this project is actually a critical bit, which is actually the link between the offshore wind and getting the power onshore.
The purpose of this substation is to convert power from wind turbines. Then we'll ship it to shore. On shore, it will be converted back again to AC and onto the national grid in the UK.
So I think it contributes significantly because without these kind of transformers, we wouldn't get the power onto the shore.
We are assembling in two sites. So we'll do the main structural building in Thailand. Then it's shipped over to Norway, where we do the second part of the integration scope.
Building in a modularized way allows you to build at the same time, and that is a time saving, which also leads to cost efficiencies. Building modularized allows also to build in the yards that are specialized for it, ensuring a good quality, a safe working environment, which all lead to a better quality product at the end.
This is the Dogger Bank C project. The topside is finished. All equipment is installed inside the topside. And now we are getting ready to do the loadout of the topside onto the barge for final installation offshore.
For Able, we are doing all the engineering. We have to have the overall picture on what is happening all through the vessels and the transportation and the key site. Then we will build up a package, and we will send that over to Mammoet. They will have their expertise look at it.
Being involved in an early phase from a heavy lifting and transport perspective helps massively to streamline the interfaces and make sure that the logistics of a project goes as smooth as possible.
Mammoet has engineered all transport arrangements of this project. We've done the ramp arrangements, ballast calculations, ballast arrangements, and the weighing arrangements. The weight was approximately 9,000 tons in total.
So basically, we bring the module, jack it up with FBT, drive it forward to the ramps, and from the ramps, we will transfer the load to the barge.
We have installed 344 axle lines underneath the topside, combination of 22 axle lines and 18 axle lines, and in total, 16 trains.
We will load it out from quayside to the barge. It will happen with the SPMTs from Mammoet.
We've assembled all our SPMTs on the quayside, assembled all our ballast pumps on the barge. We've driven our SPMTs underneath the topside, positioned as per drawing, pick up the topside and do the side move towards the quayside. And we will do the loadout of the topside on the barge, set it down on the barge and drive off the trailers.
We're all focused on getting the module transported from A to Z in the most efficient way possible. Less time spent, less fuel consumption, less material misusage. So in that sense, yeah, I'm very proud on that.
Mammoet always wants to stay on top of the game with regards to providing the right tools for the right kind of project. And seeing a trend doing a lot of modularized building of structures, Mammoet is also tailoring the equipment to suit for that. So I would say we have done that as long as Mammoet exists. We always try to accommodate our specialisms and our way of working for what the client needs.
We have been working with Mammoet for several years, and we have built a good collaboration. And Mammoet is always acting professional and easy to communicate with.
Mammoet sees Norway as an important market, and we have been there for decades. We have done big crane jobs like the High Wind Tampen with one of the biggest cranes in the world. Mammoet knows the yards, Mammoet has the equipment. We are right situated to support our Norwegian clients, and we are planning to do so going forward.